You grew up in Baltimore, and I read that your father had a record store.
Yeah, he did.
So you grew up listening to...
Oh, not only that, I worked in the store from the age of 12. In those days, you worked in your father's store. You didn't get paid. You know, you just went to work.
But you got an education in music.
I got... Partly, I once was also the Peabody Conservatory in Baltimore, a very good school. But I was the classical music buyer for the store by the time I was 15. But my father
the classical
was,
musical buyer at 15?
Yeah. But I mean, that wasn't so hard to do. Baltimore was in New York. But there were it was a very sophisticated town in many ways. But my father took a liking to modern music because he found he had records in the store that nobody listened to. So he would take him home to listen to him. He didn't know anything about music, really. He was a car mechanic and ended up in this odd business. Mm-hmm. And but he was a very smart fellow and learned a lot along the way. And at one point, he took the records home. He said, "Well, if they don't, I have to listen to them to find out what's wrong with them. And if I know what's wrong with them, I won't buy the bad ones anymore."
So this was contemporary classical music. Nobody was listening to it.
It was Shostakovich and Bartok, and we would listen to it. And after a while, and I was his companion in listening. He learned to love that music. He became a great. He became a great expert. And you have to remember, this is the 40s and 50s, and so. Bartok was only recently had died, and Shostakovich was still alive. So we were talking about really contemporary music.
But he was wondering why people weren't listening, and then
he ended up loving it.
Ended up learning.
But the other thing is that the most two important things I learned from him. One is that there was all kinds of music in the world because we had it all in the store. He never told me which was the good music and what was the popular music. He didn't make those decisions. We had the crooners over here, and we had the jazz bands over there, and we had the what we called hillbilly music. Don't worry, this is Maryland. Don't forget. In another part, then we call it country western. We would never call it hillbilly anymore. But to me, they all had quality. The genres didn't themselves impart quality to it. Mm-hmm. The second thing I saw him do many, many times, and I was part of it. Someone would come to the cash register. He would hand them a record, and they would give him $5. It's an absolutely normal transaction. I saw it happen from the earliest days. So the idea that money and music could be associated was this part of life. I've had three record companies. I had my first one when I was around 28. And I've had three record companies since then. The business of music is very interesting.
Yeah.
Years ago, Ornette Coleman said to me, "Philip, don't forget, the music business and the music world are not the same thing."
Uh-huh.
And he was absolutely right. But I love the music business.
You do. Mm-hmm. It's changed quite a bit, hasn't it?
Well, we're catching up with it. We're trying to.